Hello, good morning, my dear students. See, in the last lecture, in the previous lecture, we have started our new lesson, that is a periodic classification of elements. Okay, so in this lesson, we have learned about the two scientists, that is a Rovellian Christ and a new Planck law of octaves. Okay, so we have discussed in detail what are the drawbacks, what are the merits, okay, and how many elements they were able to classify in. And see, in the last previous lecture we have completed a test also. So today in this lecture we will start with a new poem, that is a Mendelian periodic table. See, when these two scientists, Mr. Rovellian Christ and the new law of octaves, when these two scientists were not able to classify all the elements in a systematic way in a periodic table. See, as you know that in a Rovellian Christ, that time nearly 15 to 16 elements were discovered, okay? But he able to classify only the 9 elements in a Christ. And then second one, that is a new Planck law of octaves, he able to classify that till a calcium. So that time he able to classify 16 to 17 elements till a calcium. So now this is the very important point, and this Mendeleev are known as the father of periodic table. Okay, so this Dmitri Mendeleev is known as a father of periodic table. Now why it is known as the father of periodic table? Because he is one of the scientists first in 1969. That time nearly 63 elements were discovered. Okay, in 1869, 63 elements were discovered, and scientist he classified these all the 63 elements in a systematic way in the form of a periodic table. Okay, so after that there are some drawbacks, and because of that nowadays we are using, that is a modern periodic table. So that we will discuss afterwards. But what he done on that time, see, the Mendeleev, what is the name of that scientist? The Dmitri Mendeleev. In 1869 he classified 63 elements in a systematic way in a periodic table. Okay, so see, what is the law of Mendeleev's periodic law? See, the physical and chemical properties of elements, periodic function of their atomic mass. Now what is the meaning of this law? See, now this both the scientists, that is Rovellian and Newland, that both the scientists arranged elements according to the increasing order of atomic mass. The same way this Mendeleev also arranged elements according to their increasing order of atomic masses. Okay, and now see, and whatever he arranged the elements in a particular box, in a particular table, the physical and chemical properties are similar. Okay, and that way he was able to classify total 63 elements in a periodic table. So he is known as the father of periodic table, because he was one of the scientists that time only 63 elements were discovered, and these all 63 elements he classified in a periodic table. Okay, so this is the law of Mendeleev's periodic law, that is the physical and chemical properties of the elements, periodic function of their atomic masses. Now periodic function means what? After a some interval of time. Means, for example, the first element and the F1 element, both the elements, their physical properties. Now in the physical properties, what we learn in the physical properties? Maybe that particular elements density same, melting point same, means similar, boiling point similar, not exactly same, but a similar. So that are the physical properties. And chemical properties means chemical properties also same, that's oxides and hydrogen. Okay, we are going to learn in detail. So this is the law of Mendeleev's periodic law. Okay, and this in 1869, very important, that is the Dmitri Mendeleev is known as a father of periodic table because he was able to classify all 63 elements in a systematic way of a periodic table. So he known as a father of periodic table. So now we will discuss about what are the characteristics of a Mendeleev periodic table. Okay, we will discuss about the most important point, that is the characteristics of Mendeleev periodic table. See, your final exam board exam also, most of the questions are asked related to about the characteristics of the Mendeleev's periodic table. So as you know that the Dmitri Mendeleev is known as a father of periodic table because he were only the scientist that able to classify the elements in a systematic way. Okay, so see here, these are the some characteristics of the Mendeleev's periodic table. So the first characteristics of Mendeleev's periodic table, that it was a base on the increasing order of atomic mass. Now what is the atomic mass? That we discuss in the class, that is a number of neutrons plus number of protons are known as a atomic mass of that particular element, particular atom. Okay, so according to the atomic mass, the increasing order of atomic mass, he arranged element in a periodic table. So this is the first characteristics of Mendeleev's periodic table. Now see here, the second characteristics, at that time only the 63 elements were known at that time. Okay, so that time how many elements? Now you know that there are total 118 elements are there in a modern periodic table, that which we are using, okay, for our study. So in that there are 118 elements are present, but at that time only 63 elements were known. Okay, noble gases were not discovered. Now what is a meaning of noble gases? See, noble gases means inert gases. Okay, inert gases means which are not take part in a reaction, means those are non-reactive elements are known as a noble gases. Okay, so that noble gases means which are that helium and all. Okay, so noble gases were not discovered on that time, but he is one of the scientists, means he were knowing that after some years there will be some noble gases will discover, and on his periodic table he kept a place for this noble gases. So he is one of the scientists. So that time he were knowing that after some years, some noble gases, some inert gases, those will not take part in a chemical reactions. Some like that elements were discovered. So on that time only he kept a place for them. Okay. So noble gases. This is the one big achievement for him. Then he was the first scientist. See, he was the first scientist to classify the elements in a systematic manner, that is in a horizontal row and a vertical column. Okay, see, before also we have learned about the Dobereiner and Newlands. Okay, so only 9 elements in the first Dobereiner, only 9 elements that are tried he can able to make only, okay? And then after that it is a Newland, only the 15 to 16 elements he able to classify. But he is one of the scientists, he is the first scientist to classify the elements in systematic manner, that is in horizontal rows and vertical columns. We see horizontal rows. Rows means this. Okay, horizontal rows. He classified the elements in horizontal rows and vertical columns. Okay, see, these are known as a column. Okay, and these are known as a rows. These horizontal rows and these vertical columns. See, these horizontal rows are called as a period. So he given the name. horizontal rows are known as a pairs, and these vertical columns are known as a groups. Okay, this is very important. Don't be confused in this. See, these horizontal rows are known as a pairs, and this vertical 1, 2, 3, 4, these vertical columns are known as a groups. Okay, do you clear this point? See, he was the first scientist to classify the element in a systematic manner, that is in a horizontal rows and vertical columns. These are the horizontal rows and these vertical columns. Now, horizontal rows are called as the periods, and there were 7 periods in a Pentateuch periodic table. So, how many periods that time he was able to discuss? 7. So, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So, 7th period was there in his periodic table. Okay, and column means this column is known as the groups. So 8 columns were there. See, this periodic table, this Mendeleev's periodic table, in detail we will learn, but you should know how many periods are there and how many columns are there in Mendeleev's periodic table. See, you have in your textbook the Mendeleev periodic table, you just see it. So in that periods are 6 only periods are given, 7 is not given. That is only the drawback of the Mendeleev's periodic table. Okay, in your textbook this periodic table it is given, but only 6 periods are given, 7th one it is not given. Okay, so that we will discuss afterwards. So how many groups were there? Groups, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. See, these 8 groups were present in his periodic table. So these rows, horizontal rows, very important, that is horizontal rows are known as a periods, and vertical columns are known as a groups. Okay, so how many periods were there in his periodic table? 7 periods, and groups, 8 groups. Okay, now the next characteristics we will learn. See, before to see the next characteristic, have you understood this all the points? See, once again I will revise it. See, we are learning about the characteristics of the Mendeleev's periodic table. The first one, what it is based on the increasing order of atomic masses. Means now whatever the elements, that time 63 elements were there. So these 63 elements, this Mendeleev's, he arranged these 63 elements according to their increasing order of atomic mass. Okay, so he arranged that all in the increasing order of atomic mass in this periodic table. Okay, then see, that time only 63 elements were known. The noble gases were not discovered. So that time the noble gases, that is inert gases, were not discovered, but he kept a place for noble gases also. Now, noble gases means what? Inert gases which are non-reactive. Okay? Now, see the next, that is, he was the first scientist to classify all these 63 elements in a systematic way in a periodic table. Okay? So, these horizontal rows are known as periods, and the vertical columns are known as a groups. Okay, so these horizontal rows are called as periods, and there were 7 periods in a periodic table, and horizontal columns are known as groups, and there were 8 groups in a periodic table, Mendeleev's periodic table. Okay, have you understood this all the points? Okay, we will continue next point. See, we are discussing about the characteristics of the Mendeleev's periodic table. See, the Mendeleev arranged the elements in a systematic order of according to the atomic mass of that element and the similarities between the physical and chemical properties. Okay. Now see, the some characteristics we have learned. Now the next characteristic, that is of vertical columns, are called as a group. See, I have told you before also, these vertical columns, are known as groups. Okay. So there are total 8 groups are there in a Mendeleev's periodic table. How many groups are there in a Mendeleev's periodic table? 8 groups are there. See, the first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, and eighth. These 8 groups are there in a Mendeleev's periodic table, and the horizontal rows, these horizontal rows are known as the periods. Okay, these horizontal rows are known as a period. See, there is one more that he first see the similarities between the chemical properties that they form oxides and hydrides that we are going to learn afterwards. So first we will discuss about the characteristics. See here, the next characteristics, this all the points whatever I have written on the board, that you all have to write in your chemistry notebook. See, the 7, each group of up to 7 is divided into A and B subgroups. Okay, now see, each group, this first to 7, each group up to 7 is divided into A and B subgroup. A subgroup elements are called as normal element, and B subgroup elements are called as a transition elements. Okay. Now see here, each group up to 7. See, in 8, and it is not divided. Up to 7, it is divided into first A, first B, second A, second B, third A, third B, fourth A, fourth B, fifth A, fifth B, sixth A, sixth B, seventh A, seventh B. Okay. So each group up to 7 are divided into the subgroup, that is A and B. So in these 8 groups, whatever the elements are present. Now see, till a third period, there is a only single element it is present. See here, this is the Mendeleev's periodic table picture it is given. In that you are able to see till up to a third period, there is only a single element is present, but fourth onwards there are the 2 elements are present in a each group. Okay, so whatever the elements are present in a subgroup, these all elements are a normal elements. Okay, and in B groups, which elements are present are known as a transition element. Now transition element means what? See, in a modern periodic table, when we are going to learn in a modern periodic table, there is one D block element in this cell. Okay, D block element. So in that, all the transitions elements are there. So transition elements means mostly metals are there. Okay, so that these transition elements are present in a B group. Okay, suppose one more example for the transition element. Suppose whatever the elements are there in between, okay, means metals to non-metals, whatever the elements are there in between, that all elements are known as a transition element. So which are the transition elements, what are the series of that transition elements, that we are going to learn when we will learn about the modern periodic table. Okay, so in A group, which elements are present? Those are normal elements. Okay, and in B group, transition elements are there. Now see, A group contain 9 elements in 3 rows. Now this A group, see, this A group is not divided into subgroups. Okay, so in these 8 groups, total 9 elements are present. Okay, and each that row is divided into a 3. See now, this is a single one row, so it contains a three elements 1, 2, and 3. Understood? So this so like that 1, 2, and 3, 1, 2, and 3. So total there are 9 elements are present in a 8 row. See in a each row 3 elements are present. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Understood? So in 8 group containing 9 elements in the 3 rows, the elements belonging to group exhibit similar property. Now see, whatever the elements are here, okay, suppose here Li is there. Just I am giving you example, and here second is a Na. So the properties of lithium and sodium, physical properties also. Now physical properties means what? The densities of lithium, density of sodium, the similar melting point and boiling point near to be similar. I am not telling you about the exactly similar, but it is a similar, and chemical properties also similar. Okay. So whatever the elements are present in a group, this first group, then physical and chemical properties are same. Physical and chemical properties are similar. And he is one of the scientists that all the 63 elements he classified in this periodic table in a systematic way. And whatever the elements are there in a particular groups, these all elements, physical and chemical properties are same. He only able to classify that. Now I told you before also, in his periodic table that there are only 6 periods are there. The 7th one is not there because he that time he was not able to classify the 7th one. So that is the drawback. So drawback we are going to learn afterwards. But up till now, maybe you have understood that how the Mendelians classify the 63 elements in a periodic table. Okay. Now see, after this, now see Li and sodium. It is a similar that they will come in a one group. See, when oxides and hydrides have it form in your book, it is one periodic table, Mendelian's periodic table, it is given. So that we are going to discuss only about the Mendelian periodic table, which elements are classified in that and how they classify, that we will going to learn in our next lecture. So what we learn in today's lecture, what you have learned, see, so we have discussed about the Mendelian's periodic table, the Dmitri Mendeleev. He arranged elements in a systematic way in a periodic table. We discuss some characteristics of the Mendeleev's periodic table. These all the characteristics are very important for you. Maybe the questions most of the time we ask on this point. Okay, so whatever the points we have learned up till now, you revise it. The next period we will discuss about in detail the position of that particular element in Mendeleev's periodic table. Okay, so thank you.